Now then, a bit of history for you. Come on, aren't you proud? Because you helped. Do you know how many people are watching this right now, live on the telly? 500 million. And every single one of them, at some point in their lives, will look back at this man taking that very first step, and they will never, ever forget it.
But how exactly did mankind make this giant leap to the moon? The Apollo space program was the pinnacle of human endeavor. Started in response to the Soviet Sputnik satellite program, then kicked on by Kennedy.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing, not because they are easy, but because they are hard.
The space race dominated the imagination of people around the world and still fascinates us today. NASA's attempt to put man on the moon was the culmination of years of scientific endeavor and triumph. And as the years rolled on and the test flights roared across the skies, NASA got closer and closer to their goal, until in 1968 they launched Apollo 8. The successful moon orbit and subsequent test flights of the lunar landing module meant that on the 16th of July 1969, an estimated 1 million people gathered at Cape Canaveral, Florida, to watch Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, and Michael Collins board the flight that would write their names in the stars. A worldwide audience of 500 million followed the rocket takeoff on a mission that would change mankind forever.
Round, round, get around,
I get around,
yeah,
get around, round, round, I get around.
Supported by the staff at Mission Control, the moon lander, called the Eagle, separated from the command module and descended towards the surface of the moon. For one moment, the world stood still. If anything went wrong, these American heroes would be helplessly stranded. Eventually, with the ground merely meters away, Neil Armstrong wrestled with the landing controls to glide the Eagle safely to the surface.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
Roger, Tranquility. We copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
My sweet Lord. My Lord.
The moon landing had been achieved. The highest television audience ever recorded sat in rapture as they waited for humanity to take its first steps onto a heavenly body. At 4 a.m. Greenwich Mean Time, Neil Armstrong descended the ladder and said the words that would become immortal.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
He had done it. They had done it. Man was walking on the moon. And as a world was watching, a new chapter of human history was relayed to the waiting masses on television. With the help of a post-hypnotic suggestion.
You should kill us all. Fight!
What do you mean you don't remember it?
The moon landing. It's such a famous piece of footage, and to say that was clever old Doctor, the way he chased the silence from Earth.
If you're going to send a subliminal message in one piece of footage, you would put it in the middle of that clip.
One giant leap for mankind.
And one whacking great kick up the backside for the silence. You just raised an army against yourself.
Everybody has seen that footage. Everyone alive. Very few things you can say that of.